Good morning, everyone. Today we're here to talk about another senseless shooting that happened in the city of Harrisburg yesterday. This tragic incident involved three young children, ages from 3 to 13. I say to Harrisburg, when is enough enough? What will you do as a community to help us in the city of Harrisburg catch these individuals who commit this crime? Now we're talking about children who are on the streets playing. And I want to say today that we are not going to tolerate this. We will be looking for an action plan to address the individual shootings. I want to assure everyone that we can make sure the safety of the residents of the city of Harrisburg is our priority. So I say to you today, if you know who you are, and you're on the streets, and you're committing this crime, we will be out there after you. I have put 30 to 40 additional law enforcement officials on the streets. So if you want to commit the crime, we're going to get you. So today, I'm here with Councilman Ralph Rodriguez, Commissioner Carter, our superintendent of the Harrisburg School Districts, Mr. Terman, and also Lieutenant Gouch. I will now turn it over to Councilman Ralph Rodriguez.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Thank you all for being here. A tragic day in the city of Harrisburg, but just know Harrisburg City Council, as well as the mayor administration, takes this as a high regard, as an urgent matter, and no shooting should be tolerated. But when we speak of the youth and minors, it's just something I could not really even gather words for. But just know our Harrisburg Police Department is one of the best departments in the area. And with the removal of already nearly 200 guns in the year, it's something that we consider a high priority. But this is a call to action. No one can just stand around and wait for the help to come. All parents and guardians, I come to you today as a father of five. Together, we can make the progress that we're looking for with unity. So please, if you know anything, if you see anything, say something. You could always call 211, 311 for the city for help. And we're here. And now I turn over to Commissioner Carter.
Good morning. Thank you. It was a tragic incident yesterday. The one person had surgery, and I understand, I'll let Lieutenant Gouch fill you in, but I understand that they're doing better. It's just unfortunate, you know, that people will glorify gangs and what have you and stand on a corner and just recklessly and haphazardly shoot into a crowd of kids. And I say to you, for doing that, we're going to bring the noise. We're going to find out who you are, and we're going to bring the noise, and you will be apprehended for that. So I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Gouch.
Good morning. So in reference to yesterday's events, I'll just do my normal spiel, as I typically do for you guys and gals. Yesterday around 5:30 in the afternoon, Harrisburg police were dispatched to the area of 18th and Regina Streets for reported shots fired. It was 3:30. I'm like 15. I screwed up the time there. It's 15:30. I was looking military. So around 3:30 in the afternoon yesterday, Harrisburg police responded to the area of 18th and Regina Streets for reported shots fired. The initial report indicated that there was a juvenile or a minor that was struck. Upon officer's arrival, they did locate a 11-year-old female who was shot in the abdomen, stomach area. That female was loaded into an ambulance and actually was immediately treated by officers and their initial responding officers. They did a really good job of initiating the treatment, the emergency care. The juvenile was loaded into an ambulance and then was taken to a local hospital for emergency care and treatment. The juvenile did undergo a couple hours worth of surgery, from my understanding, and as of this morning has been removed from critical condition, is in stable condition, and is successfully, hopefully, to continue recovering throughout the day and in the week, is expected to recover at this point. A little while later, officers were also advised that there was a three-year-old that had been shot. The three-year-old subsequently had a, I hate to use the word superficial wound, but especially when you think of a three-year-old being shot, nothing's really superficial, but a significantly minor in comparison to the 11-year-old. The three-year-old was also taken to a hospital for treatment and was expected to make a full recovery and survive. I think the initial officers and the family that was there, they kind of bypassed the three-year-old, not thinking anything was wrong. Nobody actually noticed at first that the three-year-old was shot and had an injury to their leg. And a little while later, officers were also advised that a 13-year-old was shot. A 13-year-old was transported to a local hospital. The 13-year-old was expected to successfully fully recover and was also able to speak and have a conversation with the officers at the scene as well as at the hospital. The investigation was obviously immediately initiated. Detectives, patrol officers, and forensics investigations from the Harrisburg Bureau of Police responded. And as of right now, detectives are still working via the case. Area was canvassed. A lot of community members came out. Some did show support and offer support and assistance. We thank them for that, and we wish to encourage anybody else that has information to continue to come forward. I posted on Crime Watch last night. We've already received some tips off of Crime Watch, so that's also reassuring to see, like, the community is not willing to tolerate children being shot in our streets. So obviously you guys always do a good job in encouraging people if they have any information to step forward, come forward, and let us know. So we wish to continue that as well. I do have a very good feeling that we will be making hopefully some sort of progress in these cases or in this case, and that'll come to hopefully play out in the next couple of days or weeks. But again, I think with the amount of support from the community, as well as the people that are up there, as well as the people that are not willing to tolerate this type of behavior, especially when it involves children, innocent children, I feel as though that we will hopefully make some progress and hold somebody accountable for these actions. I will open up for questions. Just mindful that it is a very active ongoing investigation, so I'm not going to be able to provide a significant amount of details or anything that will compromise the investigation. At this point in time, we do not believe the 11-year-old and the 3-year-old was the intended target. The 13-year-old, we do believe that he may have been with somebody and or associated with somebody that may have been a target, but that's still ongoing an investigation. But with the 11-year-old and the 3-year-old, we have absolutely no reason to believe that they were the actual intended target. We believe that they were just coincidentally victims that were walking down the street. I don't want to use the language that's in my head as to what type of person that is, but obviously I think we could all come to our own conclusion of what type of person that is. I think we all know. It's the person that does that is just horrible. I mean, that's just a horrible, horrible, horrible act to commit. A 3-year-old, I mean, and an 11-year-old, but I mean, I think there's probably a lot of us that have children and or parents, and I mean, the fact that I envision my own children on the street and something like that happening to them, that's why I hated to use the word superficial wound. I mean, I can't imagine any bullet wound to a 3-year-old is just, it's just unthinkable. At this point in time, we believe there's two actors. Not at this point. Nothing I'm able to release right now. It's one of the things the detectives are doing. That's just standard that we do whenever we go to a crime scene like this. We look for witnesses, both human and people, as well as any surveillance videos or cameras or anything else that we can get. The shooting was on the street. The shooting was in the 1800 block or right in the area of 18th and Regina Streets. We do believe the 11 and a 3-year-old were associated, or they were together. We do not believe there's any association with the 13-year-old. We believe the shooters were on the street, that they were just walking down the street haphazardly shooting at the group of the 13-year-old and his associates. And then, unfortunately and coincidentally, the 11 and the 3-year-old were also struck because they were in the area. We are looking at whether or not it's going to be gang associated, whether there's any sort of discrepancies going on with the gangs and any ties to the potential actors or the victim. That's still part of the ongoing investigation as well.
At this point, we have not met. We will be meeting after this, after the news release today. We will be meeting. My comment to the residents are, if you're not angry, you should be angry. You have babies on the street. The community needs to come together and help the Harrisburg Police Department. If you know something, as Councilman Rodriguez said, please say it. Please tell. You can always call 717-255-3058. That is my extension to my executive assistant. If you don't want to be known who's calling, please, we need your help. The community needs to help the City of Harrisburg Police Department. Go ahead. Address that.
So I actually had a dialogue last night with the Captain Uniform Patrol, and we started talking about preventative and, you know, proactive measures, especially for that area in reference to what just transpired. So that was a dialogue we had. We were going to meet this morning as well. I can say some of the things that we discussed last night, I won't publicize just because I don't want people to know what we're doing. There are some other, there's an element of just us having enforcement out there, but there's also an element, and I think of this from the detective division wise, in reference to more secretive measures that we're gonna take in order to, if people do commit crimes, how we're gonna actually apprehend them and then hold them accountable later on in a prosecution purpose or prosecution route. But I will be meeting with him later on after this meeting as well. But we already talked, we had a dialogue last night in reference to a couple of things that brainstorming. Well, I think the last night when this transpired, and like I said, I don't want to ill speak on the witnesses that were out there, because we had a lot of witnesses that stepped up and they did a great service to the community and to our agency by assisting the detectives. I think seeing more of that and hopefully that continuing moving forward, people that they do see something to say something. People were coming forward last night, and I don't know if it was just because of the circumstances and the nature of the victims and the age of the victims. I think that really pulled on people's empathy to really step up and to cooperate, but hopefully that continues moving forward. And if we can hopefully impact and show the people that are running around with these guns that the community is not going to tolerate it, the Harrisburg police are not going to tolerate it, hopefully that will just start to change and start to bend, and then maybe they'll obviously start thinking a different route to go in life instead of just running around shooting each other up and shooting at the neighborhoods. So the 11 and 3-year-old, we believe they're walking back from a corner store. We believe they're walking back towards the house, towards their residence when this happened. So. Off the top of my head, no. I can get those. Yeah, I have them on my desk, but there was a lot going on this morning. I didn't. So as of the end of August, we were right around teetering the number of 200 firearms that we've recovered just off the streets in Harrisburg. So obviously that number is growing. It's probably grown since then. The exact amount I don't have, but obviously that's a significant amount of guns that we've recovered and we've taken off the street, but yet they still keep on making their way back into the streets. So that's a topic probably for, excuse me? I believe it's probably about standard. It may be an increase from last year, but either way, that's showing a significant amount of firearms that the Harrisburg Bureau of Police and our assisting agencies are taking off the street, and yet these guns still filter their way back in. No, it's mostly through enforcement, through search warrants, through traffic stops, through people that are in possession of firearms they shouldn't have in the first place.
So good morning. The Mayor Williams called me last night, and she alerted me in terms of the names of the students and who they were. We put something in place very quickly to talk to Mrs. Peters last night, who's our director of student services, to identify where any kids would be affected, where they'd be going to school, to make sure there's a support network at the school with any friends, any siblings at the school, and also the adults as well. I think the one thing you kind of lose sight of sometimes is, as a classroom teacher, you know, you become attached to kids to a point where, you know, they're almost like your own children. So, you know, we know we may have some adults today who might be dealing with a little bit of trauma themselves, knowing the impact that they have working with kids each and every day. So, you know, we're going to make sure, in connection with the city, that, you know, we work very closely together to A, know the status of the children, B, how we as a district can support them, and also support anyone there who may be affected. And you're not going to know that until kids come in and talk to a social worker and say, hey, that was my cousin, I'm having a bad day. So we're going to make sure we keep those lines open for any student who's going to need some support as well.
And the 11th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th.
Correct.